This time we will look at the calculation of cross-sectional separations in ventilation systems and also at the flow mechanical balancing of external systems. Cross-section splitting is often necessary, for example, to avoid obstacles. In this case, the air ducts are splitted, the situation in question is bypassed, and then the ducts are brought together again, as we see it here on the first floor in our example. The air duct was divided into two unequal sections and reunited behind the obstacle. We also have a similar situation on the second floor, where I constructed two bypasses with identical cross-section to better show you the differences. Another challenging case for the calculation is the division of protective gratings into several smaller grates, as it can also be found here in the example. Particularly in the case of large insulation, it is often necessary to divide them. Since you have to face reality in these cases, you should at least know what consequences this has on the pressure losses of your system. With a linear air duct calculation, you can also calculate and analyze such special cases. So we start a calculation and the network is detected and calculated. Let's take a closer look at the results here. Using the search function, I can easily display the relevant section in the dialog. I can also easily recognize them by the color highlighting and the indentation of the affected lines. The flow paths created by the division are also compared with each other. For each individual flow path, the volume flow rate is determined that results from the existing pressure loss. With the identical cross-section on the second floor, logically an identical volume flow has been calculated. However, if we now look at the situation on the first floor, we see that the airflow conditions are different. Because of the different sizes of the ducts, we also calculate a different volume flow. So here for the smaller cross-section, 278, and for the larger duct, 492 cubic meters per hour. The calculation therefore exactly reflects the situation that would also occur in reality and does not work with any simplifications. Now let's have a look at the other situation, which is often encountered with large volume flows, namely the division of protective gratings into several smaller ones. This means that we also need cross-section splitting on the outside of the central air handling unit. For this reason, the escape and exhaust air systems are also calculated as separate systems with linear. So if we search for the grate, the system switches to exhaust air, and we also see that despite identical grate sizes, the total air volume flow is distributed depending on the individual flow path with their individual fitting parts. And at the end, each flow path has the same total pressure loss of 30 Pascal. Everything is checked down to the last detail and calculated exactly. That's workflow instead of workaround.